it is hot. Like, it feels much hotter outside now than it was in the daytime in the blazing sunshine.
I don't know if I have ever seen two bigger douchebags than Nick and Matt Jackson.
He was clucking like a chicken.
He actually did do that here, yes.
But yes, they're the greatest douchebags. Conan is the greatest talker. I mean, he would be a great mouthpiece for Andrade.
Yes, like, that's the...
Much better than Vicky Guerrero.
That'd be a perfect match they should do. Matt Sydal and Dante Martin, basically they do a lot of things that a lot of other wrestlers do, but they jump 4 feet higher than all of them in the process. The biggest sunset flip I ever saw, set against an actual sunset in the background. And it is so artistic. It was like Van Gogh. It was wonderful.
It's like Van Gogh?
Yes.
I've been looking at my MGF coin. He's a bigger heel than ever right now.
I see. Gotcha.
Oh, this guy got me hook, line, and sinker.
Has it ever been explained what these masks Bear Country wear are? Maybe it's a face caught in a bear trap, and that's why they're Bear Country? I don't know.
He's getting closer every time he gets out
there.
Yes,
yes.
Then it's not a big deal if he gets even closer, but he loses. He gets even closer, but he loses. Because you know that the day will come when he will win. You still have the faith in Jungle Boy, even if he is not beating Kenny Omega on a Saturday night show in front of 1,000 people for the AEW World title at the wrong time. A lot of these A&E documentaries where it starts with a guy saying that he got all bloody and people were freaked out and he liked it, usually ends with them being serial killers. This led to a guy just being a professional wrestler. So that was a nice change.
He's in college, he's out on a date, having a good time, and things are going well, and he goes to kiss her goodnight, and she says, "I had a lovely time, Frank." His heart
sounds like the A&E biography of Vinny V to this point so far.
Kind of a little
chubby, not a great athlete, but loved wrestling. Went on a date, girl didn't know his name.
Weird and creepy. Yeah. Yeah. I did once have a girlfriend. I had friends who refused to believe she existed until I presented physical evidence that she was there in front of them.
You know, there are a lot of similarities as well between Dude Love and Vinny V.
In some ways.
Kind of, yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
And as he's trying to free himself, his ear is yanked off. And Flair's reaction watching from backstage is, quote, "Stupid motherfucker."
And they kept pushing, and they kept pushing, and they kept pushing, and finally Vince goes,
"Uh-oh. Should we just let him go?
Barry. Time out, buddy. He's still going. He's wound up. Look at him.
Bryan. We can't hear you. Send.
Right. You're telling me I dropped right in the middle of my great rant?
It's not my God, he's killed him. It's not my God, Undertaker killed him. It's my God, they've killed him. And that's a deep little look into what was going through his mind about who was at fault here.
Undertaker knows that he was on top of the cage, and all he could think as he is standing there is, please move, please move, please move. Mick, move. Because he thought he was dead, too.
He gets chokeslammed into the thumbtacks. He is tombstoned. He is mercifully pinned. And they go backstage. And Foley's first question is, he wants to make sure the Undertaker is okay.
I never watched that match again with The Rock and Mankind. I have never watched the full Hell in a Cell match with Foley and Undertaker. These matches where people nearly killed themselves or suffered very, very serious injuries, I could not bring myself to watch them again. And I watched a lot of matches multiple times in that era.
And he says, I find myself 45 years old, sitting in my basement all alone. And he said this, I look around my house. I am 45 years old, sitting in my living room all alone. And I'm doing fine.
You're Mick Foley.
Yeah, but I'm happy about all that.
Bryan, I didn't watch one single wrestling match this week.
I'll bet you're wildly excited about that, aren't you?
Well, give me a good rest.
The windows are open, and my neighbor has taught his parrot to cuss out my cat, who also enjoys sitting in the window. Since this upsets the cat, I was wondering if you had any advice on how to get rid of a parrot.
I would hang out outside the window, and I would teach the parrot to say, "Fuck you, Franklin. Fuck you, Franklin." And I keep saying that until the parrot learned to say that. And once the parrot starts saying, "Fuck you, Franklin," to the neighbor, the neighbor's going to want to get rid of the parrot, right?
Sounds right. I have these garden hoses that are the kind that if the water's gone, that they shrivel up, you know, so I don't have to. Anyway, I had two of these.
Vinny knows all about those.
Bryan, how dare you?
Karrion Kross and Scarlett arrive, but Johnny Gargano attacks, and we get a pull apart. Because God forbid we go 4 minutes on NXT without a pull apart. Thank God Samoa Joe is here to stop all these pull aparts.
Zaya spins. She throws that kick. Mercedes puts her chin out and kablammy. We get a KO here. And the fact of the matter is, if Zaya's going to be doing spinning kicks and her opponents are not going to be putting a hand up, then this probably ain't going to be the last time this happened. There is a photo of me super kicking Nick Gage. And my foot looks so deep in his face that the skin of his face is formed around my boot. It is the most amazing picture you've ever seen. But I swear to God, I would not have cracked an egg with this super kick. Karrion Kross is also doing main event matches. So if they plan to call this guy up, like, if you're telling me that this Johnny Gargano is going to beat this Karrion Kross to win the NXT title, I mean, we're in Miz cashing in Money in the Bank on Drew and then running away like a coward territory. I don't need that twice in 1 year.
He tried the sunset flip powerbomb on the apron. Bronson just squishes him, just sits down on him, and Swerve is trapped. His arms and legs are flailing. He looks like a complete buffoon. It's great stuff.
I was sad to see Bronson lose, but I was happy because I think he was losing because he's going up to a better paying job on the main roster. But this top dollar, he's got one speed, 100%. This guy, I mean, he's lucky he didn't wipe out like 9 rows of fans.
The Young Bucks managed to reach new peaks of douchebaggery every single week. These
absolutely
mustaches,
incredible.
It's blinding. They're such giant douchebags, it hurts to look at them. Brandon Cutler, who knows what he's doing? His face is in horror. He says, oh no, I'm spraying the Bucks, but he can't stop spraying.
He is so scared that he is frozen in fear, including his thumbs being frozen on the triggers. And he sprays, and he sprays, and he sprays, and he gets yanked off the apron, but he's still spraying in the air as he takes a bump on the ground. I was dying.
Christian says something about how he is like a quarter triceratops or something. Lucha's very excited to hear this. They may be related. They walk off together. Jungle Boy continues to lace his boots. This one, like 2 minutes, Jungle Boy was mute.
The women love Jungle Boy. The guys love Jungle Boy because he just seems like such a sincerely nice guy. But he needs to be able to talk.
Yes.
And hopefully he can get that.
As Steven Friedman put it on Twitter, my son is a total asshat, but man, he can deliver a promo. All Rebel has to do is climb through the ropes, run across the ring, and break at the pin. In the process, she goes down and she does not get back up.
No.
A knee injury. Nyla has to drag her to the ropes so that she can drag herself out of the ring. She was never seen again.
Dislocated kneecap was like horrible, but they relocated her kneecap and she was out drinking after the show and everything was fine. So that's good.
And Sammy does the big RVD flip dive over the pretty black mats, over the ringside barrier onto MJF in the crowd. And they showed this from a camera angle where the camera was behind MJF. So you see a tiny little Sammy Guevara pitched up on the top rope. And he comes flying right at you like Mick Foley would have called this for his elbow. Would love this camera angle.
It was so amazing to see a video like this that was recapping like the worst 18 months of many people's lives. And do it in such a way that you actually were sad that this era was over.
That is a good way to put it. We have not done this in a while, Bryan, but it's time to vote. Honestly, I don't think it's close. As much as I liked a lot of things on NXT, there were things I did not like on NXT. There was nothing I didn't like on AEW, and a lot of stuff I loved. I'm going to vote for All Elite Wrestling.
AEW is a winner this week. I thought it was a great show. It was a fantastic opener, a fantastic main event. So it is, in fact, the winner.